I'm Jack, and in my early adolescence, I was diagnosed with lymphoma, a type of childhood cancer. It took 3 years of intense chemotherapy before I was given the all clear, and these 3 years had huge implications on me and my family. But since then, I've achieved some amazing things. It started simply with completing my GCSEs and my A-levels. At the same time, I joined several sports teams. I started competing at local and then regional and finally international events. I visited countries I'd never imagined and was in situations I'd never believed I would be in. My search to better understand the disease that had debilitated me for 3 years took me to start a biochemistry degree, and now I'm competing in masters. I now feel I have the skills to be able to make a contribution to the field, however small, of cancer research, so that some people, maybe at some point, could have the opportunities that I've had. In 2010, 324,000 people were diagnosed with cancer in the UK. In 2007, 51% of people diagnosed survived for 5 years after treatment, and 45% of people survived for 10 years or more. Science has achieved some amazing things to get these incredible results. But I'm here today to say that this is not good enough. There are over 7 billion people on this planet. That's 7 billion minds, 7 billion new ideas, 7 billion contributions to be made. And as of yet, scientific research has failed to harness this huge resource. It's my voracious want to better understand cancer that has enabled me to develop my own ideas, but it's the 7 billion of you that can make them into something amazing. So what can we do? There are two main issues and reasons for fatality during cancer treatment. And the first is complications during treatment. This doesn't happen too often. And the other is chemotherapy resistance. And this is a biggie. As patients are treated with chemotherapy, the tumors and tumor cells can adapt so that the chemotherapy used becomes useless and doesn't work anymore. Resistance is a huge problem and is not dealt with often until it's far too late. 41% of breast cancer patients develop some type of resistance during treatment. Resistance is by far cancer's strongest ability, and whenever you compete in the sport, you're always told to use your opponent's best ability against them. And this is what I plan to do. How can we use cancer's best ability, its adaptability, against it to our advantage? I suggest using two treatments. The first treatment is used in such a way that cancer must adapt to it, and that adaptation path leads it to a new form that is far more susceptible to a second treatment. And I used an analogy to explain this that I call the jocks and the nerds analogy. As a tumour develops, there are several different types of cells with slight differences, and we shall represent these slight differences with three examples. In life, there are three main types of people. There are the nerds, the massive geeks and geniuses of the group. There are the jocks, the sporty, less academic types, and there are the sporty nerds. The jocks hate the nerds and the nerds hate the jocks, but everyone hates the sporty nerds. These guys are good at everything. They'll thrash you in a test and then kick your ass on the football field after. It's infuriating. And I'm sure we've all known someone like this. And it is the sporty nerds that represent the biggest issue in cancer. How can we use these sporty nerds' adaptability against them? If you were to set an academic challenge, like a chess tournament, the nerds would win every time, and the jocks would fail miserably, but the sporty nerds could probably hold their own. If you were to set a physical challenge, the jocks would win every time. The nerds would fall at the first hurdle, but the sporty nerds would probably rise to the occasion. In both instances, we managed to get one group to be removed, but both times, the sporty nerds remained and adapted. How can we use this adaptability to our own advantage? So picture this scenario. You grab a load of people off the street and you put them all in one room and you lock the doors. And every day you walk in and you randomly shoot 5 people. This represents the tumour and the first test. However, before we started, I had put a big pile of bulletproof equipment in the middle of the room. Now the nerds, being the geniuses they are, instantly realise what it is and realise that It being there probably means that something bad is going to happen and they should probably put it on. So the nerds don the entire outfit. The jocks have no idea and stand there looking blank. The sporty nerds kind of get that something's probably going on but haven't quite decided what to do about it yet. So you walk in and you shoot five people. Every time you hit a jock, they go down like a sack of potatoes. But every time you hit a nerd, the bullet simply bounces off. The sporty nerds quite quickly realise that the nerds have got something here. Every time they're shot, they aren't killed. And so, the sporty nerds do what they do best and adapt and put on the bulletproof outfit as well. So you keep going until you've killed all the jocks and you're left with a room of sporty nerds and nerds happy and well inside their new bulletproof outfits. So this was the first test and we've managed to get the sporty nerds to adapt. And now we must start the second test. So you make sure all of the doors are locked and no one can get out, and then completely flood the room with water. The nerds were never any good at swimming anyway, and drown instantly. But more importantly, whereas before the sporty nerds would have been quite good at treading water, they are now covered head to toe in heavy bulletproof equipment. And as a result, they don't really stand a chance either, and consequently drown as well. So you can see how we used the first test to cause the sporty nerds to adapt by putting on that bulletproof equipment. Little did they know that by doing so, they were making themselves far too heavy for our second test, the swimming test. And as a result, they drowned as well, and we managed to get rid of everyone. And this is what I want to test in cancer. Can we use an initial treatment combined with a bulletproof vest that only certain adapted cells can utilize? And that adaptation pathway means that they are far more susceptible to a second treatment. I really want to try and research this idea. I think it could have some legs, but I can't do it without your help. Scientific research funding has taken a huge dive recently, and it's very difficult to get any sort of funding. We've made a campaign on Indiegogo that you should definitely check out. There's a link in the video somewhere, and definitely there's one in the description. Check it out. It explains everything in far more detail scientifically if you're interested in that. Please go and have a look. Support us if you can, or just spread the word. Thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.